Yeah! The Lord. here for a couple moments, but I wanted to talk to you about something real powerful. Something real powerful. Tongues and thanksgiving creates your mental stability. Tongues and thanksgiving creates your mental stability. I want to deal with something real quickly about praying in the spirit and how it increases angelic presence in your life and it removes demonic issues that you have emotionally and mentally. When you're thanking God, you're coming into a covenant with the anointing. That's why Jesus took the 5 loaves and 2 fish and he gave thanks. Because there's something that happens with thanksgiving that removes mental struggles. Whenever you're praising God, you're receiving his power, his presence, and his personality. Praise is the only way that you can forgive an enemy. Praise is the only way that you can overcome your past. Praise is the only way that you can break away from things that God don't want you to be dealing with. Once you step into praise and thanksgiving, you're receiving the oxygen of the Lord in your soul. You're receiving his life inside of your being. So then you have a supernatural empowerment to flow as a woman, as a man, very different from everybody else. It gives you the advantage. If you remember in the Old Testament, there were some battles that all God asked them to do, not take out their swords and fight, not take out their battle axes, but he asked them to praise. If you remember what he did with Joshua, he told them to go around the mountain, the wall 7 times and praise. It was praise that caused the Lord to win the battle for Joshua. Bible said in Thessalonians, I believe it's chapter 5, verse 18, or within that proximity of the text, it talks about give thanks, for this is the will of God in Christ Jesus. If you can't even locate what God assigned you to do or what's your assignment in life, if you give him thanks and you praise him, you will invite the Holy Spirit to give you clarity. Thanksgiving is a link to clarity with God. Praise removes confusion. If you can't hear the Lord for yourself, you don't know what he's saying to you, you need answers concerning situations, while you're praising him, you're inviting the answer. If you notice what Daniel did, the king is destroying everybody in the kingdom. Everybody is being murdered by the king because he wants to know what does his dream mean. Daniel goes and seeks God in the night. And Daniel begins to pray, but he mixed it with praise. And while he was praising God, God gave him the answer, not only of what the dream was, but God told him the exact dream that the king had. He delivered people from death through his own praise. The king stopped killing people because Daniel was able to come to the king and give him what he was looking for. That's why he was murdering everybody in the kingdom. Daniel unlocked the answer, the voice of God, through praying, but also praising God, which I just was talking to you about, thanksgiving and tongues. Thanksgiving and tongues are two things. You don't even have to be in the will of God for your life currently. If you give him thanks and you pray in the spirit and you take that time with the Holy Spirit to pray in the spirit, he will bring you clarity and he'll show you the direction to take next. Oftentimes, you don't even have the fullness of the anointing that you need to live in the assignment that God wants you to live in because you're not praying in the spirit, you're not praising God, and you deplete yourself. You deplete yourself. Remember the Bible said God told Adam in Genesis chapter 1 to replenish the earth. It was a part of the blessing. Let me give you a revelation. Not only is the earth this planet, but the earth is you. Because if you remember, God made you from the dust of the what? The earth. So when God told Adam, I'm going to bless you, he wasn't dealing with materialistic stuff. Though the blessing attracts materialistic stuff, you know that. It attracts materialistic stuff. But that wasn't the blessing that God was talking to him about. God was talking about his mind being sound, him having the mind of God, him having the empowerment mentally, prospering in his soul. So when God gave him that empowerment, then God said, go use this blessing to replenish the earth. I want to take you another direction, not just this planet, but the earth is also you. You came from the dust of the earth as far as God's creation, not your spirit, but your physical body. So when you're replenishing the earth, you're replenishing your origin. You're bringing yourself into the God realm, into the God nature, into the sound mind, where your mind is in the wisdom, the understanding of the Lord. You see things from his perspective, and he can speak to you nonstop in a day, in a moment, in a situation, in an event. After God gave him the blessing, which is the empowerment of the mind. See, saints, I just want to say this. The blessing is the empowerment to prosper, but where? Not financially, is the blessing to empower mentally. Because God can't even give you a house if you got a trailer mindset. He can't give you liberty if you got a bondage mindset. He can't give you perfection if you got a flaw mindset. He can't give you love if you got a bitter mindset. He can't give you peace if you got a revenge mindset. So your mind is the headquarters where God can get every other good and perfect gift to you. So the blessing was the empowerment to prosper mentally, because you can be in a palace and still have a pit mindset. The children of Israel was in the presence of Moses physically, but they was in the presence of Pharaoh mentally. You think about that. You think about that. The children of Israel was in the presence of Moses in the physical realm, but they was in the presence of Pharaoh in the mental realm, in the emotional realm. That's why they were testifying about Pharaoh. They said, Pharaoh used to feed us this. Have you brought us out here to die? But when we was with Pharaoh, he used to give us this. He used to supply us with this. He used to bless us with this. And remember, they was testifying and giving glory to Pharaoh in the presence of Moses. So they was in the presence of a prophet, but they were still mentally in the presence of bondage. And you know that Hosea 12:13 let us know that by a prophet was Israel brought out. So prophets carry the power to bring you out. They carry the power to preserve you. That's the second part of the text. What I want you to see is that you have to take time for you to replenish you. Oftentimes, you go to people about stuff that you really supposed to be going to Jesus about. Because people just take your business. They slander you. They fight you. They laugh at you. They are two-faced towards you. Take the things that you go through, to Jesus. By praying in the spirit and by praising God, you enter into the courtroom of heaven. That's what Psalm 100 let us know. Enter into his courts with praise. So you need justice. Why? Because the devil tries to bully you. The devil tries to manipulate your mind. The devil tries to make you miss God. So you need justice. Even if you never had somebody do you wrong, you still need justice. Because you have an enemy that doesn't want you to be prosperous, doesn't want you to have joy, don't want you to have health, don't want you to have sound-mindedness and peace of mind. So either way you pit it, you still need justice. So when you go into praise, you're telling the Lord, I want you to perfect that which concerns me. When you go into praise, you're telling the Holy Spirit, I want you to deal with every situation in my life and bring your will to the forefront in every situation. If you do praise, and if you do pray in the spirit, Jude tells us that you'll build up yourself in your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost. When you pray in the Holy Ghost, you go to the God realm of faith. This is the faith where Jesus walked on water. This is the faith where Jesus rose from the dead. This is the faith where Jesus spoke to that 12-year-old girl, Jairus' daughter, and resurrected her. You notice the first thing Jesus did when Jairus' daughter was raised from the dead, he said, give her something to eat. What is the Lord saying? He's saying, replenish her. If she is not going to die, she must be replenished. If she is not going to go back to this dead place again, she has to eat. That's what you got to do as well. You got to feed your spirit. You got to take that time out with you so that you can have all the nutrients, all the power in the spirit that you need. When you praying in the Holy Ghost, is a feeding tube. God begins to feed you his spirit, his mysteries, his wisdom, his clarity, his reactions. Your reactions is going to decide whether or not you make it to heaven. How do you respond to a storm, to a temptation? How do you respond to hatred? How do you respond to love? How do you respond to mercy? How do you respond to conviction? How do you respond to correction? How do you respond to instruction? Your reactions is going to determine your eternal life. So when you're praying in the spirit, you're receiving God's reactions. When you are thanking God, you're receiving his reactions. So thanksgiving and tongues are two major anointings that you walk in to be built up, to be empowered by the Spirit, and to have the flow of Jesus nonstop in your life so that you can be victorious. All of you all, bless you in Jesus' mighty name. We give God all the glory. I'm getting word that we reached 1 million on my main page. We give glory to God for that. And thank every one of you all that shared the broadcast, that invited. You know, I was joking around, but at the same time, I was still serious. I had prophesied. I said, before this weekend is over, Jesus told me that we will reach over 1 million souls. We did it. And I praise God. And I give God all the glory. But Jesus is not a man that he should lie. Those of you all that are connected to me, you know I stepped out of the boat and said that Jesus told me that he was going to do it. And then I put a time frame. I said, before this weekend is over. I didn't just say like he was going to do it. I said, before this weekend is over. I said, I'm prophesying that. And it happened. I'm getting word that we at 1 million. Is that confirmed? Is that confirmed that we at 1 million? But Jesus' word came to pass. So glory to Jesus. And praise God. And thank you, all of you all that shared the broadcast. And bless you in Jesus' mighty name. How many of y'all enjoyed this word? I'll be live on Periscope not too long from now. Be live on Periscope not too long from now. I'm going live on Periscope not too long from now. Not too long from now. We going live on Periscope not too long from now. Download the app. share the video, share it on Prophet Joshua Holt's page so somebody can be blessed and somebody can hear the word of God. Thank you.
You're a good, good father. Who you are, who you are, who you are. I'm loved by you. Who I am, who I am, who I am. You're a good, good father. It's a love so undeniable. I can hardly speak. It's so unexplainable. I can hardly think. You call me deeper still. Call me deeper still. Yeah.